Tag TV updates you about Corona situation in Canada and around the globe.
You're watching Tag TV.
Hello viewers, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay with another episode of South Asia Focus. The number of coronavirus cases is growing exponentially across the world. The South Asian region, which was relatively less affected until few days back, is also registering hundreds of cases every day. However, the only silver lining in this huge crisis appears is the level of preparation and commitment by these countries. New Delhi has chalked out a multidimensional plan to fight the battle while keeping the country in lockdown. Other South Asian nations have followed the suit.
Indian authorities have transformed the sleeper carriages of decommissioned trains into isolation wards to treat a rising number of coronavirus cases. India's network of trains, the country's lifeblood, has been idle. But some old train coaches have been given a new purpose as prototype quarantine facilities. This is in line with the attempts being made to boost the capacity of hospitals that have limited availability of isolation wards.
In the coaches, we have removed the middle berths and the one laboratory of Indian style, which is blocked and converted to the shower room, where the bathing facility to be done for doctors, nurses, and also for patients. And there we have fitted new bottle holders, magazine bags for keeping reports, and we have fitted the mosquito nets from outside the window.
Among other measures, in India's northern Sangrur district, the local administration installed a so-called safety station, which involved various workers hand washing with touch-free basins and having their temperature taken before being sprayed with disinfectant. A similar initiative was started in southern Chennai city, where people on two-wheelers entering the city were being sanitized. The Indian government claimed initial success in its fight against the coronavirus epidemic, saying it would have been hit with 8,20,000 cases by next week had it not imposed a nationwide lockdown. Meanwhile, Indian capital New Delhi and nearby industrial city of Noida went through sanitization drives, specific areas which have been declared coronavirus hotspots and sealed to curb further spread of the deadly disease. New Delhi Municipal Corporation and Noida Police said they were spraying hypochlorite solution to disinfect roads, buildings and by lanes in potential hotspots and clusters.
सारे market areas road फिर से cover करेंगे, एक-एक by lane भी हम cover करेंगे। तो हमारा tanker आ गया जैसा कि आप देख रहे हैं। इसमें हमने 1% hypochlorite solution prepare किया है, इससे पूरे area में हम disinfection करेंगे। और जहाँ तक containment का सवाल है, यहाँ पे अब कोई इस बाबा रोड एरिया से बाहर नहीं जा सकता है जो भी एसेंशियल आइटम्स रिक्वायर्ड होंगे वो यहां पे ही डिलीवर होंगे
रेसिडेंट्स वर सीन गेटिंग एसेंशियल आइटम्स थ्रू द गैप बिटवीन गेट्स एज दे वर नॉट अलाउड टू स्टेप आउट फ्रॉम सम सील्ड रेसिडेंशियल सोसाइटीज इंडियन गवर्नमेंट हैज नॉट जस्ट बीन टेकिंग मेजर्स टू स्टॉप द स्प्रेड ऑफ द वायरस इन इंडिया but has also been supplying essential generic drugs to the world. Large stocks of the anti-malarial drug hydroxychloroquine were sent to India's South Asian neighbors and far-situated friends like the US, Brazil and Israel. Meanwhile, Nepal moved to extend a two-week lockdown by another week in the hopes of containing the coronavirus.
यो चाहिँ हामीले लोकल ट्रान्समिसनको फेजमा प्रवेश गरेका छौँ लोकल ट्रान्समिसन भनेको स्टेज दुई होइन एपिडेमिकको स्टेज दुईको अवस्था हो र अझै पनि हामी कम्युनिटी आउटब्रेकमा वा कम्युनिटी ट्रान्समिसनमा गइसकेका छैनौँ
The number of cases in the Himalayan nation of 30 million people increased to 9 over the weekend, according to Health Ministry officials.
Moving on, the pandemic is taking heavy toll on the business and trade around the world. A multi-trillion dollar loss has been predicted, and economies with low per capita income are going to have worst markets in decades. The garment industry of Bangladesh, which is the second largest in the world, has not been operating for days and the uncertainty looms over its restart. Hundreds of thousands of workers are sitting unemployed at homes with little hope of old days returning for them.
The garment industry of Bangladesh, one of the largest garment industries in the world, has become silent in past 10 days. The sewing machines are shut and the tens of thousands employed by it are sitting at home. The lockdown was supposed to be lifted earlier by 5th of April, but now when the pandemic of COVID-19 is spreading even faster, the future looks uncertain.
এই করোনা ভাইরাসের কারণে পুরো ফুল গার্মেন্টস এরিয়া বন্ধ করে দেওয়া হয়েছে আমরা বন্ধ আছে যাতে এই করোনা ভাইরাস স্প্রেড আউট না হয় ইভেন তো আমাদের পুরো নারায়ণগঞ্জের সমস্ত শিল্পাঞ্চল বিশেষ গার্মেন্টস ইন্ডাস্ট্রি যেখানে লোকজন বেশি সোশ্যাল ডিস্টেন্সের অ্যাভয়েড করার কারণে আমরা এটা বন্ধ করে দিয়েছি
If industry bodies are to be believed, Bangladesh is said to lose around $6 billion in export revenue in this financial year, as major international brands and retailers have cancelled the orders. Bangladesh is second largest producer after China and has its clients in almost all countries around the world.
করোনা ভাইরাস ইটস এ ন্যাচারাল ক্যালামিটি সারা বিশ্ব এই এ থেকে উত্তরণের উপায় খুঁজছে সংগ্রামে লিপ্ত এতে বিশালভাবে ক্ষতিগ্রস্ত হয়ে গিয়েছে আমরা রপ্তানিকারকরা আগামী 3 থেকে 4 মাসের অ্যারাউন্ড $9 billion আমাদের অর্ডার ক্যান্সেল হয়ে গিয়েছে এতে ক্ষতিগ্রস্ত আমরা যেমন পাশাপাশি শ্রমিকরাও কিন্তু শঙ্কিত তারা তাদের বেতন ভাতা কীভাবে পাবে আমরা চেষ্টা করছি সরকার চেষ্টা করছে যে কোনো মূল্যে শ্রমিকদের বেতন ভাতা পরিশোধ করার জন্য আমরাও ঘুরে দাঁড়াবার জন্য পথ খুঁজে বেড়াচ্ছি
And it is not just about the revenue, but a large number of people are also said to lose their employment. The two groups, which represent the vast majority of the ready-made garment and knitwear manufacturers in the country, that the cancellation of orders have severely affected the structure and millions of jobs were at risk.
করোনা ভাইরাসের কারণে আমাদের অফিস 10 দিন বন্ধ দিয়েছে অফিস খুলব কবে তাও জানি না কিন্তু মাসে আজকে 7 তারিখ বেতন পাবো কিনা তাও জানি না আমরা অনেক অসুবিধায় আছি
Low wages have helped Bangladesh build its garment industry, with some 4,000 factories employing 4 million workers. Garment exports accounted for $34.1 billion, equivalent to 84% of the country's overall exports in the fiscal year through June 2019.
Amid coronavirus lockdown in Pakistan, country's blood banks are running dry, posing a grave threat to the lives of thousands of people suffering from thalassemia and leukemia. Most of the hospitals and blood banks are facing acute shortage of blood due to non-availability of blood supplies in the wake of restrictions imposed across Pakistan to restrict the spread of coronavirus.
Thousands of thalassemia patients in Pakistan can die if they are not supplied with blood vessels in time. There is an extreme shortage of vessels as the entire medical attention of the country has shifted towards the fast rising pandemic of COVID-19. As per a non-profit organization, Jamila Sultana Foundation, Pakistan has over 100,000 thalassemia patients, each requiring 3 to 4 pints of fresh blood per month. Students are the primary donors for most blood banks across the country. But due to closure of educational institutions, it is no longer possible to hold blood donation camps, resulting in severe shortages.
लॉकडाउन के हवाले से जो सबसे ज़्यादा बड़ा मसला हमारे पास आ रहा है कि जो ब्लड डोनेशंस हैं उसमें बहुत वाज़ह कमी आई है और थैलेसीमिया के मरीज़ों का प्रॉब्लम ये है कि इनके अंदर खून की किल्लत की वजह से खून की एप्रोप्रिएट जो है वो सप्लाई मौजूद होनी चाहिए तो क्योंकि ब्लड डोनेशन नहीं आ रहे हैं तो हमारे पास थैलेसीमिया के मरीज़ों के लिए खून की कमी वाकई हो रही है और इनकी ज़ाहिर बात है हालत के लिए ये चीज़ सही नहीं है.
Blood banks and organizations dealing with thalassemia and leukemia patients are worried that it would be impossible to supply blood if the lockdown imposed due to coronavirus is extended. Organizations dealing with these diseases launched a frantic call for blood donation on 3rd April, which received an overwhelming response from the public. Doctors at blood banks said the donation had saved hundreds of lives.
जितने अब तक कोरोना से नहीं मरे हैं उसको आप 10 टाइम मल्टीप्लाई कर लीजिए इतने बच्चे मर जाते. मेरे पास अभी भी मतलब एक तो ब्लड ना होना, दूसरा 70% बच्चे कराची में जो कराची से बाहर से आते हैं ब्लड लगवाने, बलूचिस्तान से, अंदरून सिंध से, ठीक है, यानी कश्मीर तक से आते हैं क्योंकि कराची में फैसिलिटी ज़्यादा मिल जाती है उनको, बहुत अच्छी मिलती हैगी. अच्छा फिर दूसरा अच्छे अच्छे कंसल्टेंट कराची में बैठे हुए हैं तो वो सारी चीज़ें बड़ी इंपॉर्टेंट होती है. तो मेरे हिसाब से कम अज़ कम मतलब मैं अगर लगभग या ये कहें रफली एक अंदाज़ा लगाऊँ 200 से 250 बच्चा मर जाता.
Thalassemia is an inherited blood disorder in which the body makes an abnormal form of hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is the protein molecule in red blood cells that carries oxygen. The disorder results in excessive destruction of red blood cells, which leads to anemia. Stem cell transplant is the only treatment that can cure thalassemia, but only a small number of people who have severe thalassemia are able to find a good donor match and have the risky procedure done.
Moving on, the COVID-19 pandemic has further worsened the life of people of illegally occupied POK and Gilgit-Baltistan. While the regional police have seen it as an opportunity to oppress, Islamabad is hatching even devious plots. Activists accuse that Islamabad is mobilizing its army to illegally occupied regions under the pretext of taking measures against the coronavirus. The local leaders on the other side have said that the region has not been granted even a penny out of the amount Pakistan received in aid from the World Bank. They also say Pakistan has been negligent towards the health of people who are most vulnerable to the disease.
Journalists and media personnel in illegally occupied Gilgit-Baltistan took to the streets against the police brutality. The demonstration was carried out after a journalist was tortured by police while reporting from the ground amid the COVID-19 lockdown. Journalists say that the government has issued special passes to media personnel to report during pandemic, but police is not letting them cover anything.
صحافی کو زد و کوب کرنا اس کو تشدد کا نشانہ بنانا میرے خیال میں یہ ریاستی دہشت گردی ہے اس کو روکنا چاہیے جب ڈی سی پاسز جاری کرتا ہے تو پھر کوئی تک نہیں بنتا ہے کہ ڈی سی ایس سی کو کہ وہ آ کے اس کو تشدد کا نشانہ بنائے اور اسے کام سے روکے جب تک صحافی نشاندہی نہیں کرے گا تب تک نہ تو ایڈمنسٹریشن کامیاب ہوتی ہے نہ صوبائی حکومت کامیاب ہوتی ہے
The state of Pakistan, which controls the region, has put both implicit and open sanctions against the media, and anybody daring to go against them is booked under draconian sections. Journalism seems to have died under the autocratic rule in the region, and there seems no hope at the end of the tunnel, with Islamabad only tightening the noose around the civil liberties and human rights of people. The activists have even accused Islamabad of exploiting the global crisis of coronavirus to set its own agenda. They say Pakistan has stepped up its efforts of imposing a military rule in the region. They are mobilizing a large number of troops to convert the region as one of its army bases.
Pakistan army Gilgit-Baltistan mein bade paimane par فوج تعینات کرنے کا ارادہ رکھتی ہے اور یہ فوج جو تعینات کی جا رہی ہے اس کے لیے انہوں نے کرونا وائرس کا بہانہ بنایا ہے کہ لاک ڈاؤن کو زیادہ مؤثر بنانے کے لیے محلے کی سطح پر گلگت بلتستان کے شہروں میں فوج تعینات کی جائے گی اس کے ساتھ ساتھ یہ خبریں بھی آ رہی ہیں کہ گلگت بلتستان میں گورنر راج نافذ کرنے کی تیاری کی جا رہی ہے اور اس کے لیے یہ پروپیگنڈا کیا جا رہا ہے کہ گلگت بلتستان کی اسمبلی کے تمام وزراء غائب ہو چکے ہیں منظر عام سے ہٹ چکے ہیں اور عوامی ریلیف کے کاموں میں کہیں بھی دکھائی نہیں دے رہے
The activist also claimed that a large number of Punjabi people are migrating to POK. They have used water route of river Jhelum and Mangla Dam to escape a proper screening. Pakistan has time and again claimed on international platforms that it has been tirelessly working for the welfare of people of GB and POK. But the reality reeks of colossal conspiracy and discrimination. Information Minister of the region accused Islamabad of discriminating against GB in fight against COVID-19. The region didn't receive its share from $200 million aid received by Pakistan from the World Bank.
Federal government ne sabse badi zyadti ye ki ke dekhe jo ek bahut bade program ke तहत jo hai World Bank ne jo Pakistan ke liye funds jo diye کہ جی چاروں صوبوں میں COVID-19 کو ہینڈل کرنے کے لیے یہ ڈسٹریبیوٹ ہو گئے فنڈز اس میں گلگت بلتستان کو ابھی تک شامل نہیں کیا گیا یہ ایک بہت بڑی مطلب افسوس کی بات ہے
بارڈرنگ چائنا گلگت بلتستان از پرون ٹو COVID-19 پینڈیمک اے لارج نمبر آف چائنیز ورکرز انجینئرز اینڈ سیکیورٹی گارڈز ورک ہیئر ان سی پیک پروجیکٹ But Pakistan has not paid even a modicum of heed to its concerns and has let its citizens suffer at the hands of stooges it has created itself to exploit and suppress them.
Mm-hmm. Moving on to war torn Afghanistan, where the Kabul establishment is taking several measures to control the pandemic of COVID-19. While on one side, it has released 100 Taliban prisoners as the first step in peace process to contain the violence, on other, it has stepped up its efforts in a relatively peaceful atmosphere to fight the fast-spreading coronavirus.
The Afghan government freed 100 Taliban prisoners as a first step in a peace process with the hardline Islamists. The decision was taken even after Taliban suspended talks on a planned prisoner exchange, crucial to moving to formal talks to end years of war. Prisoners released from the Bagram prison said they were looking forward to the return of peace in the country. Differences over the prisoner release question have been complicating US brokered attempts to create a lasting peace agreement to end more than 18 years of conflict in Afghanistan. A February pact between the United States and the Taliban, under which US-led international forces will withdraw in phases in exchange for Taliban security guarantees, is the best chance to reduce US military involvement in Afghanistan. But peace hinges on talks between the US-backed Afghan government and the militants. A prisoner exchange is meant to build confidence on both sides for those talks. Despite this week's setbacks over the prisoner releases, Washington has said progress had been made. Many experts call the release of the prisoner a wise move, as the country, they believe, cannot put itself at risk amid coronavirus crisis. Meanwhile, the government also stepped up its efforts of disinfecting crowded areas in the capital, Kabul.
بیش از 30 موتر که مختلف نوع است وسایت ما اونو ساحاتی که ازدحام است جاده ها هست گشت گذار مردم زیاد است حتی پلان گرفتیم که مکرویان ها بلاک ها بلان منزل ها را توسط پرسنل خود با همکاری برادرای وزارت صحت عامه تمام بلان منزل ها را هم ما ضد عفونی بکنیم.
The government ordered all shops, restaurants, mosques and public transport in Kabul to close for 3 weeks. The country has recorded around 400 confirmed cases of coronavirus with over 10 deaths. There are fears Afghanistan's vulnerable health system, devastated by years of war, would be overwhelmed by an outbreak.
ما بسیار زیاد فعلا به تشویش هستیم برای اینکه سطح کسایی که مصاب به کرونا هستند روز به روز زیاد شده میره بالا میره شهروندای ما هم با تاسف با بی‌پروایی با این برخورد میکنند و ما کوشش میکنیم که با جدیت روی یک پلانی که وجود داره هم آگاهی رسانی کنیم هم توصیه کنیم هم از قوای قهریه استفاده کنیم جبران کسایی که مراد نمیکنه به خانهشون میشن.
Meanwhile, Afghan authorities have quarantined several health workers and doctors as Afghans fleeing hard-hit Iran have helped spread the coronavirus. Afghanistan, already battling a shortage of food and medicines amid a Taliban insurgency, has recorded several cases in its bustling territories of Herat and Kabul.
Taliban has also launched an anti-corona drive at its own level, where it is educating people about the virus. With that, we come to the end of this week's episode. See you next week. Goodbye and take care.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.